Hello students, and a very warm welcome to Economicspedia. Today we are here to have a discussion on the econometrics topic, and the topic is autocorrelation and partial autocorrelation function. So in this session we will mainly be focusing on what are these, that is what is autocorrelation and what is partial autocorrelation functions, how the two are different from each other, what is their purpose of existence. On these topics we will be focusing on this in this session. In the time series we have AR, MA moving average functions, and ARMA, that is autoregressive moving average process. Writing the general form, we have phi naught, phi 1, yt minus 1, phi 2, yt minus 2, and so on. Let's say phi p, yt minus p, plus of epsilon t. So here AR is of order, how many order? It is AR of order p, right? Now, how moving average look like? It is epsilon t plus of theta 1 epsilon t minus 1 plus theta 2 epsilon t minus 2 plus, let's say, theta q epsilon t minus q. And when we talk about, so this is MA of order q, isn't it? MA of order q. And when we have a combination of these two, that is, let's say, phi naught, phi 1, yt minus 1, phi 2, yt minus 2, and phi p, y of t minus p, summation of epsilon t plus theta 1 epsilon t minus 1 and t minus q. If we have a summation of these two together, then this forms an ARMA model of order p comma q. Right, so these are the basic formats of AR, MA and ARMA. Well, the process, if they are mentioned that this YT follows this AR process of order P or MA process of order Q or ARMA process of order PQ, we don't have any problem in running our regression. But the problem arises if we are unaware of the stochastic process. That means what type of the process we are dealing with. If we don't know that, we cannot proceed towards our inferences. Isn't it? So that is why, to understand and to know that what type of stochastic process we are having, I'm using the term stochastic because it can be AR, it can be MA. So I'm not just concentrating only on MA. So AR process can also be there. Hence, we can find that this identification of a particular stochastic process, this is done by the autocorrelation and the partial autocorrelation functions, ACF, or we can write rho k. Okay, k here implies the lag length. So, I am denoting ACF as rho k. Now, rho k is defined as the correlation between yt and yt minus k. Alright? And this is the correlation. So, rho k is defined as correlation between yt and yt minus kth term. Here, k being the lag length. Now, if I just expand this, I am getting this, the value of correlation. We can write it into variance of y of t minus k. Alright? Now, I am denoting the covariance of yt and yt minus k, let's say, by gamma. And here is the variance of yt and this is the variance of y t minus k. In our assumptions, we have already taken that our error term is following the CLRM assumptions. So from there, we have the variance for the error term to be constant. That means homoscedasticity is assumed. So because of homoscedasticity, we can write variance of yt and variance of yt minus k will be equal. And I am taking the variance of both the term to be gamma naught. So here we have gamma naught. Okay. Therefore, rho k we can define as gamma k by gamma naught. This is our ACF function, isn't it? So this is the function. Now I am taking, let's say we start with the AR series, and let us see that what will be the type of graph we will be obtaining for the ACF function, and from there let's see what inference we can do. So let us take and start with AR1 process, that is leg length 1. So here we can write yt, I am taking the general form. So yt is equal to phi 1 yt minus 1 epsilon t. This is the standard format of AR. Now if I multiply on both the sides a term yt minus k, let's see what we can get. yt minus k, phi 1 yt minus 1 yt minus k plus epsilon t y of t minus k. Okay, in this equation I'm not going to change anything but take expectation on both the sides, that is expectation of yt minus k, phi 1 expectation yt minus 1 yt minus k plus expectation epsilon t y of t minus k. After applying the expectation, we have this scenario. Now, as I have told you that the expectation of yt and yt minus k, we are denoting it as the gamma k because it is nothing but the covariance. So, we have gamma k, phi 1, and here it is the covariance between yt minus 1 and t minus k. So this is, I am representing as gamma k minus 1, and we have this as 0. Why? Because expectation of epsilon t is 0. Okay, so I am erasing this. Now see, for AR1 process we have this format, that is gamma k is equal to phi 1 gamma k minus 1. Now if I put k equal to 1, we have what? I have gamma 1, phi 1, gamma naught. For k equal to 2, phi 1, gamma 1. Now put the value of gamma 1 over here. That is, we have phi 1 square gamma naught. Okay? This is the final format. This is the final format. In the same way, if we take the length of k as k only, then we find that gamma k is equal to phi 1 to the power k gamma naught. Okay? In the same fashion, if we go on, we will be obtaining this. So, gamma k's value for the AR term, we are getting it as phi 1 to the power k gamma naught. Okay. And now try to look into this ACF function where rho k is equal to gamma k by gamma naught, isn't it? and we have obtained gamma k's value as this thing. So I am just substituting this value into this equation, and let's see what we can obtain. Okay, so here it is phi 1 to the power k gamma naught by gamma naught, isn't it? Just that gamma k is being substituted over here. Now we have found the ACF for the AR function. Here the gamma naught get cancels out, so rho k is equal to phi 1 to the power k. And if k is equal to 0, then we have rho k to be equal to 1, isn't it? Now, from this particular equation, what we can conclude? That the value and the type of the autocorrelation function depends only on the value of phi 1. So phi 1's value in determining the stochastic process, the type of stochastic process, is very much important. Also, we have found that the value of phi 1 is again important if we want to find out that whether a series is stationary or not. Okay, so here there is a two link. Rho k's value depends on the value of phi 1. Now see, if we have phi 1, mod of phi 1, let's say mod of phi 1 is equal to 1, then what is it? We have rho k is equal to 1, right? And rho k equal to 1, this implies that the current period can remember all the past period equally, because the presence of error is not getting minimized under this condition when the phi 1 value is equal to 1. Presence of all the past error terms, not just past but current as well. When we have the presence of all the past and the current error terms, obviously that series will be lead to non-stationarity. And see what happens if mod of phi 1 is less than 1. So we can find that rho k tends to 0 as k tends to infinity. Now this is a condition that talks about the curve of the autocorrelation function. So here we are finding that if the value of phi 1 is less than unity, then that will lead to the autocorrelation function to be 0 as the lag length is increasing. So as lag length keep on increasing, the importance of the past error terms keep on decreasing. That means we start valuing the recent error terms more than the past error terms. So here we can say when the rho k phi 1 is less than unity, is that importance of error term diminishing. That means it keep on forgetting the past values. It cannot remember the past value equally as the series could remember under this situation when the phi 1 is equal to 1. Okay, I hope the two conditions are very much clear, because these two conditions determine the value and the shape of the autocorrelation function. And based on that, we ultimately can determine whether our series is AR process or MA process. Now based on this, I am going to draw how the autocorrelation function would look like. Okay. Now this is our rho k. Autocorrelation is measured over along this side. And let's say this is our k. That means the lag length we are measuring on this axis. So when we have this scenario, that is when phi 1 is less than 1, what I said that the rho k will be keep on diminishing. So we have the autocorrelation function to look like this, under, rather to write it phi 1 less than 1. Then we have this condition. Then how the function will look like if we have the phi 1 is equal to 1. Then that situation we have like this, where phi 1 mod of phi 1 is equal to 1, and this is unity. This is also unity. If you have any kind of doubt regarding the why the my values are different, well, you can just draw it at the same height and mark it as unity. So this is, you can see this is the parallel lines, parallel two lines, they are not intersecting each other, and the gap remains the same. That means here, if there is non-stationarity existing, then we cannot overcome that non-stationarity. But in this scenario, where phi 1 is already less than unity, the system is already under the stationary situation. So this is the autocorrelation function for the AR series. Now let's see how the autocorrelation function would look like for the MA series. MA with lag length 1 looks like this, right? This is okay, and here we have already found the correlation between yt minus 1. Three correlation we have found. We will be obtaining 1 minus theta 1 square, sigma square, okay, then we will obtain theta 1 sigma square, I think theta 1 sigma square, yes, yes. This will be for k with lag length 1, and this is covariance actually, not the correlation, and the covariance as 0 once the lag length is greater than 1 or for equal to 2. So these are the covariance function that we obtained for MA. Now try to see how the autocorrelation function would look like. See, till k equal to 1, let's say if this is k equal to 1, we have a value, isn't it? Like this, we have a value. But after k equal to 1, once it is greater than 0, we have the value as 0. So it suddenly drops down to 0 from here. Okay, this is the value of, this is the shape of autocorrelation for MA function. That means it suddenly drops down to 0. And being suddenly drops down to 0, so this implies that with any lag length greater than the order of the series will give us a function like this. Okay, so this is what is autocorrelation function and how the autocorrelation function would look like for the AR and for the MA series. That is all of this session. If you have any kind of further doubt, please let us know below in the comment section. And thank you for watching this.